Hi, I'm George Pearson, and I'll be showing you how you can use backgrounds as free Photoshop Elements overlays. Now, if you like this video, make sure to hit that like button. Don't forget to share, and of course, don't forget to subscribe. You can also learn a lot more about working with Photoshop Elements from my complete training course, and there's a link for that right down there in the description. Okay, let's get to it. Photoshop Elements overlays are things that you put on top of a picture, like the balloons right down here. Let's go over here to the layers. You can see that this layer up here is above this layer down there. It's been overlaid on top of this picture. Let me show you how this is done, and it's done using one of those free backgrounds that comes with Photoshop Elements. Let's just get rid of this one here. I'll close that out, and I'll open up my original image, which is this right here. Now, to start off with, she's too far to the left, so I want to move her over a little bit. I also, for this trick, need to take her off of the background up here. So the first thing we'll do is to right-click where it says background and choose Duplicate Layer, and then choose OK. This way we can change our background without losing our picture up here. Now she's not where I want her, so I'll pull her to the right a little bit. I'm going to hide the background first. There we go. Pull her to the right. I want her over here, so she's about centered on the page, kind of like that. And I have too much on the left-hand side, so you'll need to fill this bit with something. Now, since there's a white background here, this one's easy. I'll just take my white foreground color right here, grab the paint bucket, and just fill that like that. If you have a different background, you may need to do some fancier work to fill your background in, or hopefully start off with a picture that already is fairly well centered. So there we go, there's our basic image all set to go. I'll show the background again. We can now change this background to something else. And you can do that by coming down to Graphics. And in here, lots of things. There is the top one. Just click on that and the background changes. If we go back to our layers, you'll see here the background has now changed to that. Okay, let's go back to our graphics again. Now most of these graphics will not really work out very well as overlays. But a few of them will. Like this one right here at the balloons. We'll be doing this one in this video. There's also this autumn leaves. This will work as an overlay. It'll put things in front of her though, which you may or may not want. One down here, Japanese lanterns can work. So you want something that has some distinct things in it which will look nice on top of your picture. And there are quite a few of those that will work. Here's one of some pine trees down here. That'll work, so you can work with those pine trees. Here's some different kinds of balloons over here. Here's a bird on some wire, something else right down here, baby toys. All these things, this little dinosaur thing down here, all these will work out fairly well as overlays. This, of course, will work out very well as an overlay, almost like a frame, a blue dot frame. Now let's take a look at the process to do this. I'll use this one up here. This is the balloons. I click on that, and it automatically changes my background over to that background. Now, before we leave here, notice that some of these have a little blue triangle in the upper right-hand corner. These ones that I haven't used yet. When you're working with your backgrounds here inside of Photoshop Elements, most of this stuff has not been downloaded onto your computer. It hasn't been installed. To install it, all you have to do is just click on it, and then Photoshop Elements goes up online. You'll have to have a currently active internet access to do this. It goes online and it downloads that one onto your computer. It's now on my computer, so this one's already been downloaded. Once they're done, just click on it, and it then changes the background to that background. Okay, let's take a look at that. Here's our layers. There's that new background. If I hide that, there it is. There's our background. Now, take this background layer, right-click, and choose Duplicate Layer. Since we need the balloons overlaid or in front of or on top of our portrait here, we need to pull this layer above that layer, and it's now on top. Now we need to remove all of this stuff in here. Now the way I like to do this is just with the magic wand. This usually will work out just fine. And that's right there. And I'll set mine at new. The tolerance is at 34. This is the default, and it's usually pretty good. If you're not getting enough, you can go back and you can use the add button to click a little bit more to get some more included. But I think this will work out okay. Click in here someplace. Okay, I'm not seeing any marching ants anywhere in here, so that's all selected. I'm seeing it around all the balloons. That's perfect. But I've selected this and not the balloons. So we need to invert this. go up to select, come down to inverse, and now the balloons are selected. Notice that we have these holes in here where all those highlights are. I need to get rid of those holes in there. So we want to add those to our selection, but I don't want to accidentally add the background back in again. So I want to limit my selection here just to each one of these. So come down here, it says contiguous. Check on that. That means touching. And then click on the new or add right here next to the new, the add right there. And now I can click into each one of those holes. And then we should be able to add that in with just a couple of clicks. If it's not really working out that well, it's not too good here. Let's switch up here to the first option. This is the quick selection tool. This may work better for us right now. Yeah, that works out pretty well. And I'll just paint right on top of those little highlights and work our way through. And this will then get those highlights for us. Now, the reason I'm doing this is because if I don't, we'll have holes there where those are. We'd actually be able to see through that, which of course wouldn't work out very well. So just go through and using this tool, paint right on top of each of those little highlights, and that selects them. And then we won't have any holes showing in our picture. Okay, that's good. There's our selection. Now that that is done, all we need to do is to click on a layer mask right here. That converts this to a layer mask, and then we can see the portrait in behind all those balloons in the foreground. So there we go. We've now used that background, a copy of that background, as an overlay of these balloons on top of our regular picture. Now they're kind of dull looking once we compare to the bright colors in here in the picture, so let's adjust that as well. I'll go up to Layer, come down to Adjustment Layer, and I'll use Hue Saturation right there. Now here where it says Use Previous Layer to Create Clipping Mask, make sure that is checked, choose OK. That will then apply this adjustment just to that one layer. Now I want to have more color, so I'll just make these more saturated. And then I'll bring my darkness or lightness down just a little bit. Just a touch, a bit more saturation. And there we go, they're a lot brighter now. You can see the effect by clicking on this little eye right here. There's before and there's after. So they're a lot more exciting now. And there it is. So you've used a background here from Photoshop Elements and used it as a layer instead, and then converted that into an overlay. Now there are quite a few of those that will work. Let's go back here to our graphics. I'll just scroll down and point out the ones that could work. This thing here could work. The green areas could be where you're looking through. So that could be an overlay. Different kinds of balloons, this will work as an overlay. We already mentioned that, of course. And there's that dinosaur again that worked nicely as an overlay. This thing right down here, it has some little cars in it. That'd make a good overlay. This would make a nice overlay, kind of a frame effect by overlaying this. So as you can see, there are quite a few of these that actually will work as overlays. You just need to scroll through and take a look at that. This one will work as an overlay. Just use this center section. It kind of becomes a picture frame that way. And this also will work over here as an overlay. That's crayons across the bottom. A good overlay for a kid's picture. So there it is. There's the idea about how you can use some of these backgrounds in here. This would also work right there. Use some of these backgrounds and use them on top of your picture as an overlay instead of using them in behind as a background. And if you had fun with this video, make sure you hit that like button and of course click on share as well. When you do that, it really helps out my channel. Also, don't forget to subscribe and take a look at my complete training course for Photoshop Elements, and there's a link for that right down there in the description. Okay, and I'll see you next time.